Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out this new model I just designed. It's a giant heart ring, or a very small heart bracelet. And if you fold it out of smaller paper, then it'll actually fit a finger. And if you fold it out of bigger paper, then it will fit a wrist and be a bracelet. And it can also be modified to go on an earring band like that, so you can make earrings. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this ring, I used a 6-inch square of this fancy duo paper, which I bought on Amazon. But for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to show you from an ordinary 6-inch square of kami. Now, if you want a ring that will actually fit on your finger, then I recommend dividing the square into 4. So I'm going to show you how to divide this 6-inch square into 4 3-inch squares. So first, fold it in half and crease sharply, and unfold and rotate, and fold in half in this direction. And once again, crease sharply. And now unfold, turn over so that the ridge sticks up like this. And now you're going to make a little tear right at the top here. So just very carefully try to tear right on the crease. And once you get the tear started, then put the paper down so that the ridge sticks up like this. And holding like this, spread your hands apart so the tear goes right down the middle, like that. And now we're going to do the same thing with this sheet. And let's start the tear from the fine edge instead of the rough torn edge. So rotate and make a little tear right on the crease. And once again, put it down so that the ridge sticks up and pull your hands apart. And here you have a 3-inch square. But for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fold it from a 6-inch square. And I'm going to use purple because it shows up better. And I'm going to get rid of this black. All right, so let's begin heart colored side up. So I'm going to make a purple heart on a white band. And let's fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Okay, now let's take this corner and fold it to the top. And unfold. And now let's rotate so that the long edge is on top. And now we're going to fold this flap up so this corner touches this crease and the fold goes through this corner. So just fold it up so that the corner touches the crease and the fold goes through this corner. And when everything lines up, make your fold. All right, now we're going to fold this edge up to this edge. And we're folding on this edge. All right, now let's fold this flap behind right on this edge. So line it up and pinch so that the two edges line up. And by the way, these two edges should also line up. Okay, now we're going to divide this long edge into thirds. So let's fold this flap over. And it should go a little bit to the right of this point and fold it over so that these two edges align like that. And now we want to fold it back and this should be thirds. I'm going to zoom in so you see what it should look like. So you're aiming for thirds. You might have to adjust these folds a little bit until your thirds are exact, but it doesn't really need to be exact. But okay, well, when you have thirds, then that's good. Let's unfold this flap and let's fold it behind so it's like this. And now actually crease it. Well, you don't need to crease it too hard, but about like that. Okay, Now let's unfold this flap again. And now we're going to stick it into this colored pocket. So open up the pocket and stick it into it, just like that. Okay, so this is going to be the band, like that. Okay, let's unfold this flap. Okay, so it's like this. And let's fold this whole flap up, and this one too. Fold it up so that the fold goes between this corner and this point right here. So you're just folding these two flaps up just like this, and try to just fold from this corner right to this point. Don't put a fold into here. If you did already, that's okay. All right, so fold like that. And now let's unfold this flap and let's open the pocket and let's tuck it into the pocket like that. And let's unfold this flap and let's fold it again on this crease, like how it was before. Okay, and let's rotate. This is going to become the heart. So let's open up the pocket and put your finger all the way to the back. And now we're going to make the crevice of the heart. So let's just take this corner and we're going to pinch it. We're going to just pinch a valley fold. And the valley fold can go to about here. It's really to taste. You're just trying to shape this thing into a heart. So you're just bringing it down and pinching it like that. And you can curve it also to taste. If you want a fat heart, then you'll fold it further down like that, a skinny heart further up. So something like that. That looks nice to me anyway. Okay, now let's open up the band. So stick your finger into the hole like that. And let's try to curve it. Be careful not to rip paper in here. Just be gentle. So here you have the band. Ba-dum, ba-bum. Not that kind of band. Okay, but just make it circular, shape it to taste, mold it, fashion it. It is pretty fashionable, except that this heart is lying on its side. Okay, let's make it stand up proud. Ooh, this heart is getting flattened in the process of my folding. Okay, much better. All right, so now both hearts are proud. And here is the circular band. Well, it looks more square. What can I say? I'm a square guy. Okay, there it is. And there's the heart. And I'm gonna turn it around so you see what it looks like on the backside. And so you see from the backside, there's the white heart. From this angle anyway. And when you turn it around, there is the purple heart. All right, so there you have it from 6-inch paper. And if you want to stick around, now I'm going to fold it from 3-inch paper. So take your square that you hopefully already divided into fourths, and take the fourth, and let's fold it, let's turn it over with the colored side up and fold diagonally in half. Okay, and let's fold this side up. This is the rough side with the rough edges. I'm gonna fold the clean side with the clean edges. So fold this corner to the top. I'm gonna go a little bit faster now. And unfold and rotate. And fold this edge up so the corner goes to the crease. And we're folding through the corner like that. And Now fold this edge to the top. And let's fold this flap behind right on this edge. And now we're going to fold the bottom edge into thirds. So let's fold this flap over, make sure that these edges align. And we're folding it a little bit more than this point. We're gonna estimate thirds. So let's wrap it around this point. Well, if you want, you can first try to get your thirds like that. Okay, now let's wrap it around so it's a mountain fold. And let's unfold here and let's open the colored pocket and stick the flap into the pocket. Okay, and let's turn over and unfold this flap and let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this, let's zoom in and let's fold these two flaps up so that the fold aligns with this point and that point. And try not to fold this right here. I did anyway, oops. Then unfold here and then stick it into the pocket like that, and unfold this flap and fold it on the original crease like it was. And now let's open the flap and let's make the heart. So just reverse it like that. A little bit trickier when it's small, but that's the fun of it. Okay, there's the purple heart, and now it's time to open the band. Like that. Oh, make the heart stand up tall. And sculpt the band like that. Now it's ready to, oops, now I need to refold this, okay, much nicer. And now let's put this on this finger, and now we have two lovely hearts. It's a pair of hearts. And if it doesn't go on, you can just pull it out a little bit. Oop, I pulled out a lot. Okay, just however much, so that it fits onto your finger. And there we have a lovely pair of heart rings. Oh, and I should show you how to make the earring. So to make this earring, all you do is you try to get the ring off. Okay, it came off. And pull this flap out and just roll this up like this. And bring the heart over to this side like this, so it just goes up like this. And then you just stick the loop like that and the heart hangs. I didn't do a very good job. Okay, well, you get the idea. So it's like that, and you can fold the heart to the other side if you want a left earring, and then you'd have to curl this back. But anyway, hope you guys were able to fold this heart ring, and I hope if you're giving it to somebody special, then hope that they love their new heart ring. All right, have a wonderful Valentine's Day or whatever other day of the year it is. Bye-bye.